Hello students, today I am going to teach you Nationalism in India Part 7. In this, I will discuss the limits of civil disobedience movement. Many sections of the society were lukewarm in participating in the civil disobedience movement. One of them were untouchables. They could not attach themselves with the concept of Swaraj, and merely from 1930 they started calling themselves Dalit or oppressed. So for a long time, Congress ignored Dalits and it did not take their demand in civil disobedience movement because it was afraid that high caste Hindus will be angry. But Mahatma Gandhi declared the Swaraj could not come for 100 years if untouchability was not eliminated. But according to Mahatma Gandhi, we need to eliminate untouchability. If we are not going to eliminate untouchability, we cannot get Swaraj for 100 of years. He called untouchables Harijan. He gave a new name to untouchables, that was Harijan. Hari means God, Jan means people, means children of God. And he organized Satyagraha for them to give them access into temple, to public well, tanks, and roads and school. At that time, you know that Harijan were not allowed to enter into the temple. They could not take water from public well. They could not bathe in public tanks. They could not walk freely on public road, and they were not given admissions in schools. So he wanted to give them all. He wanted to give them access to all these things. He himself cleaned toilet to dignify work of Bhangis. People were hating the work of Bhangis, but Gandhiji told that work of Bhangi was very important. If they stopped cleaning toilet, then what will be the result? Any epidemic can break out. So he cleaned himself the toilet so that he can tell that he can dignify the work of Bhangis, and persuaded upper caste to change their heart. He met the upper caste leaders and talked with them and told them that they should broaden their heart and give up the sin of untouchability. That untouchability is a great sin. They should give up this sin. But many Dalit leaders were keen on a different political solution to their problem. But many Dalit leaders did not agree with Gandhiji. They were thinking that if they are politically empowered, then they will get a key to all their problems. So they began organize themselves, demanding reserve seats. So they started organizing them. They were demanding reserve seats in educational institutions, that in schools, seats should be reserved for Dalit, and there should be a separate electorate that would choose Dalit members for legislative councils. And they were demanding for separate electorate for Dalit. Already Muslims were having separate electorate. Now Dalits were also demanding for separate electorate for legislative council. What is separate electorate? I will clear it later. They wanted public empowerment, and they thought that it would resolve the problem of their all social disabilities. Dalit participation in civil disobedience movement was therefore limited. So Dalits did not participate in civil disobedience in very great number. Especially in Maharashtra, Nagpur, they did not participate. Their population was quite strong and their organization was also quite strong. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who organized Dalit into Depressed Class Association in 1931, Depressed Class Association was formed by B.R. Ambedkar, and he brought all Dalits in that association. So he clashed with Mahatma Gandhi at second round table conference. So first round table conference, already you know, was not attended by Congress, but Mahatma Gandhi went and attended second round table conference, but there he clashed with B.R. Ambedkar on the point of separate electorate. When British government conceded Ambedkar's demand, Gandhiji began a fast and took it. But you know, British believed in divide and rule, so they conceded Ambedkar's demand of separate electorate, and at this Gandhiji started fast and to the death. He said that he will not eat food till his death. He believed that separate electorate for Dalit would slow down the process of their integration into the society. He was thinking that if Dalit's electorate becomes separate, so Dalit's integration in Hindu society will be impossible. Ambedkar ultimately accepted Gandhiji's position, and the result was Pune Pact. And when Gandhiji went on hunger strike, Ambedkar accepted his views, and result was Pune Pact. They signed one Pune Pact in September 1932. By this Pune Pact, depressed class Dalits reserved seats, Dalit got reserved seat in provincial and central legislative council, but they were to be voted in by general electorate. So their seats were reserved in legislative council, but all people would vote for them. All Hindus would vote for them. The Dalit movement, however, continued to be apprehensive of Congress-led national movement. So Dalit movement did not participate in Congress-led movement, and political empowerment they believed to resolve the problems of their social disabilities. So they were thinking, if they are politically empowered, if they got reservation, if they got reserved seats in state assemblies or in central assemblies, so their all problems will be solved. Dalit participation in civil disobedience movement was therefore limited, so they did not participate in large number in civil disobedience movement, particularly Maharashtra and Nagpur region. See, here Mahatma Gandhi is on hunger strike, and B.R. Ambedkar is sitting here to make a compromise with Gandhiji. Separate electorate and Pune Pact. So first I want to clear you about general electorate. What is general electorate? In general electorate, some candidates of different parties contest election, and members of all sections living in that constituency cast their vote to elect their leader. At this time in election, general electorate cast a vote to elect any representative. Separate electorate. In separate electorate, some candidates of only Dalits or only Muslims participate in election, and only Dalit or Muslim members of society cast their votes to elect their representative. So you can understand in separate electorate what happens, that only Dalit candidate will be elected by only Dalit members of the society. No upper caste Hindu would vote for them, no Muslim would vote for them. And if Muslim candidate is there, the Muslim candidate will be elected by Muslim members of the society. And for him, only Muslim societies will vote, no Hindus would vote for them, and no Dalit would vote for them. So you can understand what will be the result of this. Suppose if any, suppose Rekha Verma is contesting election, and he needs the votes of only upper caste Hindu, so why she will go to please Muslim? Why she will go to please Dalits? When she needs only vote of upper caste Hindus? So Gandhiji was feeling problem that if this thing happened and Dalit got separate electorate, then what will happen? Then Dalit and upper caste Hindus will never come together, will never come closer, and it will create a great breach in Hindu society. In second roundtable conference, Bhim Rao Ambedkar demanded separate electorate for Dalit, and British government conceded his demand, and Gandhiji opposed this demand. Pune Pact. Gandhiji went on a hunger strike and objected to the provision of separate electorate for the Dalit. Gandhiji opposed the British since he felt that their policies would divide the Hindu society. The Pune Pact refers to an agreement between Mahatma Gandhi and Baba Saheb Ambedkar. So what is Pune Pact? It is an agreement between Mahatma Gandhi and Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Mahatma Gandhi on the behalf of upper caste Hindus and Baba Saheb Ambedkar on the behalf of depressed class. On what this agreement was there? This agreement was on the reservation of electoral seats for depressed class. By this Poona Pact, the electoral seats for Harijans were reserved in state assembly and in central assembly of British India government in 1930. Contrary to popular belief, Gandhiji was not involved in signing the pact, as people believe that this pact, Poona Pact, was signed by Gandhiji and Bhimrao Ambedkar. It did not happen so. It was made on 24 September 1932 at Yerwada Central Jail in Pune. So in Pune, at Yerwada Central Jail, Gandhiji was at Yerwada Jail at the time of this Poona Pact on 24 September in 1932. In that jail, this draft was made and it was signed by Ambedkar on behalf of depressed class and by Madan Mohan Malviya on behalf of upper caste Hindus at Gandhiji as means to end the fast. Gandhiji was on the fast, so he should end his fast. For that, this Poona Pact was signed. Gandhiji was in jail. Gandhiji was on the fast and he was against the decision made by British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald. Ramsay MacDonald gave separate electorate to depressed class for the election of the members of provincial legislative assemblies in British India. And due to that, Gandhiji went on hunger strike and B.R. Ambedkar gave respect to Gandhiji and signed this Poona Pact. So what was the result of this Poona Pact? That 147 electoral seats, that 147 electoral seats were provided to Dalits in entire India, and these were 18% to total seats allotted to general electorate. One more class was there which did not participate in civil disobedience movement, that was Muslims. Mahatma Gandhi and Muhammad Ali Jinnah, you see in this photo, Congress and Jinnah failed to compromise and gave way to division of India. Some of the Muslim political organizations in India were also lukewarm in their response to civil disobedience movement. So Muslim political organizations did not give their response to civil disobedience movement after decline of non-cooperation and Khilafat movement. So when non-cooperation and Khilafat movement was called off, a large section of Muslims felt alienated. They felt themselves separate from Congress. From the mid-1920, Congress came to be more visibly associated with openly Hindu religious nationalist groups like Hindu Mahasabha. So from the mid of 1920, Congress came in the contact of Hindu Mahasabha, and Hindu Mahasabha's influence was more on Congress as relations between Hindu and Muslim persons. As you know that Hindu and Muslims at the time of their religious processions were clashing with each other, and there were riots in various cities. As Hindus at the time of Janmashtami, they were on the roads for their religious procession, and if any opposition was made from Muslims, so immediately they started for clash. And the same happened at the time of Muharram, were in the mood to clash if any objection was made from Hindus. So there were many times, every year there were riots between Hindu and Muslims, and with the each riot, the ditch between Hindu and Muslim, both communities, was deeper. The Congress and Muslim League made efforts to renegotiate an alliance, and in 1927 it appeared that such a unity could be forged. So later Congress and Muslim in 1927 wanted to renegotiate an alliance, and it was thought by both sides that such type of unity can be done. The important differences work over the question of representation in future assemblies. What were the important point between, what was the important difference between both? That was the question of representation in future assemblies. So Jinnah, he was one of the leaders of Muslim League. He was willing to give up demand of separate electorate. He said that he will leave the demand of separate electorate if Muslims were given assured reserve seats in Central Assembly. So assured some reserve seats should be reserved in Central Assembly for the Muslims and in Bengal and Punjab, which were Muslim dominated provinces. In these provinces, his demand was to give Muslim seat in the proportion to the population. Here I want to clear in the proportion to the population. Means if 80% Muslims were there in Bengal and Punjab, then 80% seats should be reserved for Muslims, especially in Bengal and Punjab and in remaining areas where they were in less number. So there some number of seats should be reserved for them. Negotiations over the question of representation continued. So then talks were there to negotiate over the question of representation. But all hopes of resolving the issue of all parties conference in 1928 disappeared. So when all parties conference was held in 1928 to talk over the issue, but all the hopes disappeared when M. R. Jaikar of Hindu Mahasabha said that there cannot be any compromise at the question of reserved seat for Muslims. When the civil disobedience movement started, there was thus an atmosphere of suspicion and distrust between communities. So when this movement started, so Hindu and Muslims, they were having suspicion and their relations were so alienated from Congress, large section of Muslim could not respond to the call for a united struggle. So they were angry with the Congress, participate for a united struggle. Many Muslim leaders and intellectuals expressed their concern about the status of Muslim as a minority within India. Only at that time, only Muslim leaders wanted that what will be their position in independent India if we got freedom. They feared the culture and identity of minorities would be submerged under the domination of a Hindu majority. They were afraid that after getting freedom, Hindus will be in the majority and in democratic rule by majority, their all culture and identity will be submerged. Now this topic is over. Read each and every line of this topic. If you feel any problem, you can call me on phone or you can text me on WhatsApp group. Thank you.